नमः ॐ गं गणपतये नमः
You play the next one, no problem. We can go to the next one. So we... Can I use this mic? Can I hold the mic with my hand so that I can walk and... Thank you. That is it. Yes. So, what is music therapy? This is the definition given by the World Federation of Music Therapy. Music therapy is the professional use of music and its elements as an intervention in medical, educational, and everyday environments with individuals, groups, families, or communities who seek to optimize their quality of life and improve their physical, social, communicative, emotional, intellectual, and spiritual health and well-being. Research, practice, education, and clinical training in music therapy are based on professional standards according to the culture, social, and political context. What they have given the definition may fit the Western world where there is only one culture. India, where we have multicultural, multi-faith, multi-religious, multilingual country, and music is the indigenous to the clinical population in the most acceptable and effective therapeutic media. Music to establish relationship as a therapeutic medium is involved, time-tested and part of our heritage, social milieu, and family traditions for many centuries. Here, actually, the music therapy, a lot of people, they ask me whether it's a new thing in India. I said it's not a new thing. It is coming from Vedic period. It is passed down to us from centuries to generations and generations to us. In fact, the purpose of Sangeetam, the music, the swaras, is not earlier when it started. It was not for entertainment at all. They were recognized and practiced as part of the healing process. It was for the healing, even today. It's now slowly, because the Western world started practicing maybe in the World War II, when they saw that Nightingale, she started singing and it was accepted as a music therapy. But for us, it's passed down from generation to generation. The value of music, swaras and notes and shlokas and mantras, how much it has got a healing power, but unfortunately we take it for granted. And that's why there is a question coming into the present generation that whether music therapy is a new thing to India. In fact, it's not a new thing. It is coming from the Vedic period. So saptaswaras, seven basic notes, is the common bond across the genre. So, as I'm saying, music therapy in India is as old as recorded civilization. Medium for mood management. It is rooted to the Vedic time and use of music to elevate pain, trauma, physical and mental too. And it is always a supplementary. Unless it's a general, used as a general calming and relaxing, which has got general, effect. It's not client-specific, it's not for any particular ailment. It's calming, it's generalized. But when it comes to therapy, always it's a client-specific what I practice. So that's why always it's a supplementary therapy. Like we follow yoga, like we have diet programs, and various exercises, various precautions in what we are, in our lifestyles. Like that, even music is a supplementary, along with the medicine, with the treatment. Yes, it reduces. Like yoga helps, like diet helps, even music therapy helps. Yeah. So these are the, I don't have to explain into that. It is, it's a beautiful music is at, associated with it, but unfortunately the audio is not giving it. Okay. It is, yes, over 5,000 years old. It's originated from the Vedas, all we know, Rig Veda, Sama Veda, Yajur Veda, Adharva Veda, and out of Sama Veda, Gandharva Veda is the Upa Veda, from where the 64 kalas generated, and one of them was Sangeetam. It was first, it was Nritya and Natya. That's what we get it from the very, very first Lakshana Grantha, Natya Shastra, written by Bharata, that it was more Natyam and Nrityam, and Sangeetam was only as a supportive, as a along, going along with, to help the communication through the Natya Mudras. That was only. Next. So when during that Vedic period, this was the procedure followed. Of course, it was Ayurvedam. There is nothing much for me to explain into that. Everybody, every one of us know what Ayurvedam and what are involved in Ayurveda treatment. It was more employing herbs and natural elements, Jyotisham, astrology. Even today, because I am master's in Vedic astrology, I get a lot of people asking which is the right time to do this, what is the right time to get admitted in the hospital, whether I'll be coming back, whether I'll be whether I'll get a good treatment, whether there'll be a progress, all these questions keep coming. Because what we say, the kalam, in 24 hours our body is not the same. It's different. How you will, you can guess it. As a student, if you can remember, you had particular time where your absorption of the whatever you are bhaharting or you are working on is more. Like if you want to study, concentrate, do your project work or do your whatever you want to do in connection with particular job or even studies, you selected a particular time. Maybe late night, you'll say, yeah, late night if I sit and study, yeah, I can remember, I can memorize. Your sister, own sister will say, no late nights. I get up at 3 o'clock. That is okay time for me. I can definitely by heart. Your brother or sister will say, no early morning, no late night. Afternoon is okay for me. So this is the way every individual's body system, their mental conditions cooperate with you. When you want to indulge in something particular, more serious, even today I have seen a lot of people who are working with the project work. They select, yes, 2 o'clock I'll sit and do this work. Night 2 o'clock. Because they say their brain cooperates. So like that, we have even our body cooperating. So in Jyotisham, we can make out which is the right time, where the healing can be done, whether the treatment can be done, where the body, the nature, the elements, everything will cooperate with us. More detailed, ragas or whatever we have, we work with the music as of this thing. My students, Shambhavi and Meenakshi, will tell you in detail. And yes, those days, Nada Yogam, that's Nada Anusandhana, evoking a resonant response from the energy centers, that was practiced. I think all of you know what energy centers, or what we call it as chakras, you're aware of it. So each chakra had a particular bija mantra. Yes, we all are aware of it. Yam, ram, lam, mem, we can say that. But are we having that kind of energy, the power to evoke the energy what should be, as a result of chanting that kind of a bija mantra? I'll say no. Because that time, the tapasvi, that rishi, munis, yogis, had that kind of a power to utter, to chant the particular Bija Mantra from the particular chakra, and enough energy was produced that they can point out their finger, and from there the energy used to, healing energy used to pass to the rogi with whom they are working with. Even we now poke our finger and say the Bija Mantra, nothing will happen. The tapasya shakti, what they get, because even the environment helped them, there was less pollution, the chakras were much more open, the activity of the energy center was more powerful, strong to get that energy released. Even if today we want to be, any one of us will think that, yeah, I'll start running and I'll become PT Usha in 1 week. Can it happen? No. It takes months, days, months, years to get that kind of a condition, what PT Usha, where she reached, like that. It takes, but unfortunately, our environmental pollution is so high that even we practice years together, that tapasya shakti, what those people had by saying the, chanting the Bija Mantras, what they had, the healing power, very, very difficult to achieve. We cannot help it because, okay, we'll say we are taking very pure form of food and all. What about the breathing? How much we can have a air purifier and keep on giving? We have to come out. We have to see the Akasha. We have to, where is the Akasha also? All polluted air closing. That's what it is, unfortunately. So, the Bija Mantras, then Parayanam, recitation, then developed into shlokas, prayers, and Sangeetam came much, much later. Next, please. Yeah, this is my current practice, Nada Anusandhana, evoking a resonant response from the energy centers in the human body to supplement and enhance the healing process. So, somewhere as the centuries passed, the Bija Mantras, in the place of Bija Mantras, slowly the Sangeeta Swaras came. I mean, we cannot say Sangeeta Swaras may produce the same kind of the healing as much the Bija Mantras had. But yes, something is better than nothing. So, Sarangadeva, he has mentioned in his Lakshana Grantha that Sangeeta Swaras slowly started getting used in the place of Bija Mantras, because Sangeeta Swaras, the frequency, the vibration, what it can produce was somewhere it was balancing with our, synchronizing with our chakras. That is what is. Yeah, what is music? All of us know nada, resonance, flow of consciousness, shruti, pitch, swara, notes, raga, scale, laya, rhythm, bhava, emotion. All these are very, very, we have to follow this when it comes to therapy. Yes, this is my application to raga therapy, 7 chakras, energy centers, 7 chakras, 7 swaras, 72 melakarta ragas, 72,000 nadis, what we call it as energy channels, how that energy goes into various work. Yes. I think we now all are ready to experience a little bit of Nada Anusandhana. First, I want to first explain, then we can get into practice of what it can be. Vani ji, please indicate when I have to stop because I keep talking. 5 minutes before. So these are the 7 chakras which we are very much familiar with. Mooladhara, Swadhisthana, Manipura, Anahata, Vishuddha, Vishuddhi, Agya and Sahasrara. In each one of them has got different numbers of petals. Muladhara has got 4 and Swadishana has 6 and Muladhara 10 and Manipura about 10. Like that it has got. And each one of these chakras not only holds the organs, the activities of the organs, where they have to supply the energy. Each one of these also connected with the emotions. Emotions and the connectivity to the internal organ, that we have to understand perfectly before we go in for therapy work. Because any emotion, for example, if I have to take anger, anger is an emotion. But what all are connected to the emotion of anger? Can anyone of you guess, give me some points? Anger. What all happens physically when you get anger?
Breathlessness,
yes. Blood pressure raises, very good. Crunch of face, okay. Pardon? Yes, shortness of breath happens. And? Facial expression goes. Headache comes, yes, very good. Then? Yes. So, a lot of sweating happens because of a lot of palpitation. Sweating definitely happens. So, see, what all is physical connected. So, if when you are talking about anger, so first thing, anger we can say, yes, it's by nature. Somebody is born, especially with the Simha Rasi or Mesha Rasi, all has got where this happens. Second, acidity, when there is more acidity in the stomach, and that actually gives more byproduct and it starts giving the irritation. And especially you are seeing, when you are hungry, the anger is more. You have seen that advertisement where, you know, it immediately changes. Oh yeah, you eat this and then the mood changes till that, you squeeze. Hungry, chalo ye khao. And then immediately becomes sad. Because anger produces more acidity inside the stomach and its outcome is anger. As I told you, anger, you are seeing physically. BP high, anger. Then when your palpitation goes up, the anger is breathlessness. Even asthma patients, when they are having breathlessness, they get very angry. The violence is there, definitely there is things. So lot of things. And one very strong where I have seen, especially with children with neurological problem, the violence and the anger, the hyperactivity, all are connected with constipation. Most of them suffer with constipation because there is a lot of toxins build up in the stomach and all over the body toxins. Because constipation, it causes headache. When you don't have, they can't sleep, they become more irritated, they hold it. Even when we have food poisoning or constipation, we too get that. No sleep, definitely next day our work is completely ruined. There is no mood to work, no mood to continue, because our body is not cooperating. The toxins are dominating the activity, the natural activity of the organs so much that we are not able to work as per what we have to do. We will say, anybody said, please don't talk to me. I got so angry. My head is aching. I am feeling so irritated. All those things until you are cleared out of your system. If anyone of you want me to explain this in any other language, Telugu, Hindi, Tamil, no problem. Because all languages I can manage. We tune. That's one more question I want to explain before we go. We have time? Vani? Yeah, I think so. Vani is gone out, okay. According to Harmony of Human Body, a book written by Armin Hussmann, is a German doctor and a teacher and philosopher. He has written how with his research, every chakra has a pulsation and which matches to the pitch of our music. Mooladhara, which is the first thing to form when a egg get fertilized in the womb. When the first time when the egg gets fertilized, the fertilized egg has to have a pulsation, otherwise it's dead. The pulsation is equal to the C, the lower C of our musical pitch, the pulsation. When as it comes to the uterus and gets attached to the mother, the placenta, the pulsation improves. So according to that, each improvement of the growth of the chakra formation in the body, in the growing baby, inside the womb, the pulsation of each chakra gets improved according to the pitch. So we have to, all of us have Mooladhara, and the pulsation is connected to the seed. Actually it's seed, but lot of people find it difficult to sing it seed. Always they say, okay, catch C dot. That's all concession I can give, not more than that. So swaras, or the, as I said, evoking sound from the particular chakra will vibrate the chakras, and some blocked or some which is not allowing the particular chakra to function as it should be, because of thanks to our pollution, so many things. Lot of people don't even know where the Mooladhara chakra is. Yes, reading it here, yeah, it's below our spinal cord. Where is it? Where is Swadhisthana? Here. Manipura here. How many of us really felt inside us? That will happen when we do Nada Anusandhana. And that's what actually keeping on doing the Nada Anusandhana practice every day. You can see me. I am 67 plus. You ask me to talk like this till evening, you will find me in the same energy level, because my energies, all centers are very, very energized. So I keep on going on, and this has happened in many places. I had done presentation the whole day. The people were wondering, with only 1 hour of lunch break, until evening you are still. I said, yeah, I can continue till 12 o'clock at night like this, no problem, because the energy in me is so high. Because of the energy centers all the time being awakened, and the energy has been produced. So kindly, if you are able to practice this at home, and I advise whoever wants to go into the music therapy, first make sure that you are well, you are healthy. Otherwise, how can you part? Like in the aircraft, they say, any crisis comes, first make sure your safety, then you try to help others. Similarly, before doing music therapy for anybody, make sure you are energized, you are strong enough inside you to part with the energy to heal others. So kindly practice this so that you are energized. Not necessary, even you don't want to do music therapy, for your general health, because a lot of people come to me for general health and wellness program. So if anybody knows, a lot of people must be connected with the music. I can say the swaras. Mooladhara Shadjam, the bass at C pitch. Remember that, lower C. Swadhisthana Re or Re, Manipura Ga, Anagata Ma, Vishuddhi Pa, Agnya Dha, and Sahasrara Nishadam. And above us, that is aura, where we have the aura, is the higher shadjam. Swaras are the same. When we sing normally in the pitch, it is sa re ga ma pa da ni sa, is the same tune. But here, we are having the swaras coming from, touching from each part of our body, traveling through our organs, through our body system. So, I'll first demonstrate, then please join with me. Come, Meenaksh, come. You are coming to join? No. Okay. Anyone wants to sit down and practice, you can do that. If you want to sit, please come. Yeah, yeah. If you want, no problem at all. we have to, before starting, kindly inhale and exhale in the normal path to keep yourself, your body calm and relaxed. And when we are doing the chakra activation, each time you breathe, inhale, take as deep as possible to Muladhara. Then when you are exhaling, after exhaling, don't start immediately to inhale. Leave a count of four in the initial stage. Then you can hold it for some more time, 5 or 6, whatever minutes. There is no prakriya, there is no inhale, no exhale. You are allowing the vibration to settle. Then inhale, then the second, do the second chakra. And if you want to understand whether you are really touched your Muladhara, your lowest part of your body, which is touching the bottom, you will feel the pulsation. Especially for women, it's very easy to understand because the vaginal muscles will have the pulsation. You can feel the pulsation. Here, when we are breathing in, this part will bloat because we are filling. And when you are exhaling, it goes inside. So that's how you can practice. And because when the fingers, you can imagine when you go to a physiotherapist or anybody, neck is stiff, hand is, fingers are stiff, what they'll say? Do this, keep doing this, it will release. Because you have to do exercise, because your shoulders are frozen. Same thing, inside your body, each organ should be flexible. It should not be rigid. We cannot put our hand inside our mouth. You do this, this to our stomach. We cannot do. This is the only way which we can bloat our, by inhaling, we can put the chakras and the organs bloat. Then we are exhaling, it shrinks. So this process actually helps us to make the circulation, the oxygen supply much more in better way. So this is what our, we are doing the exercise to our inner organs. Nada Anusandha. This is what they used to practice in the Vedic period. So first I'll demonstrate, then you can practice. Shruti. For people to understand if music connected. Carnatic music, Maya Modagoda Swaras. Hindustani music, Rag Bhairava Swaras. And others, if they are not having understanding of the music itself, no problem. You can just follow and see how deep we had to go to produce the sound. The sound can be swara, it can be om, it can be ah, it can be anything, whatever you want. If you want to prolong it for a longer time, the breathing out, the exhale success, you can say small mantras like Om Namah Shivaya. Some can say Om Namo Narayanaya. If suppose this thing, O Lord in the heaven, or Allahu Akbar is permitted. To my surprise, a college student asked me, what's wrong if I say Deepika Padukone? I said, yeah, please say. Why Deepika Padukone? Shah Rukh Khan, Salman Khan, everybody you call, no problem. But the thing, what will happen, when you will call, you will get only their image in your mind, which is not going to help you anywhere. If you call your own this thing, if you don't believe in any God, just say, I am happy, I am healthy. That is much better than Deepika Padukone, Shah Rukh Khan. So that's it. So first we'll just start with simple swaras and then we can make it as om, ah, whatever it is. Okay. So just breathe in and breathe out to make yourself calm for at least 3-4 times. You can breathe in and breathe out. Kindly concentrate only on breathing process and see where it is touching, okay? Let us start. We are just starting first the demonstration. Start. Sa Keep your hand on your chakras so that you can feel the chakras movement, whether you are filling in your air or not. Ma. How many of you felt any tickling or anywhere? Yes? You could feel? Yes. When you keep this and say knee, you can feel that vibration in your palm. Did you feel? Knee. Keep it flat. Knee. You can feel it? See. So it is actually whole. As you are seeing, all the chakras are interconnected. As a sympathetic free vibration, you may feel here when you are saying other swaras may. But it will be stronger when you say ni. So now you see, the way we used to sing, sa-re-ga-ma-pa-da-ni-sa, this is so different when we are saying, starting sa, here. But the ma is, ma. However I try, I cannot get knee from anywhere else. Because that frequency of the nishadam, which is equivalent to what we say, the B, high B, pitch, the higher one, it is equal to that. And that C, higher C is coming here. So actually every pitch you are allowing it to, because every organ, as I said, ma is actually F. If you tune it at F, you will see ma is F. You won't believe, I have gone to the one of my friend who is a gynecologist. The first cry of the baby, because it comes from our, because this has to open up. If the child has to survive, the lungs have to open up. The first cry has to come. Otherwise, the baby is not healthy. Even if it comes a little later, some amount of damage has already happened to the brain because oxygen supply doesn't happen. So when the baby, as soon as the umbilical cord is cut off and it is detached from the mother, it has to give the cry. And the first cry always comes from the... That's why in Harmony of Human Body, he has very beautifully mentioned, we enter into the octave through the fourth. Sarigama Padanisa is the octave. Fourth is the Madhyamam. He has beautifully written, even though he is a German doctor, he has written, we enter into the octave through the fourth. Because fourth is the place where the lungs open up. And you won't believe, not the first cry which I asked, requested my gynecologist friend to record at the operation theater where she was conducting the operation and the baby was born. And the first cry I recorded, it was equivalent to F. When the sa is, the bass is C. The bass has to be C, C, E, then the C, D, E, F. So the F, after that, you won't be, nearly 20 newborn babies' cries I have recorded. All of them are in F. So it has proved that it is the same. Later on, when they start crying, quack, quack, they change the pitch according to their ability. But the very first cry, where it pushes, it's not it's first is that's how the baby pushes the lungs to open up, very struggling. If it permits, I got even in my laptop, I can make you hear the very first cry, how it has happened. It's not quack, quack, which we hear little later on. So the pitch is in F. So that is proving that our lungs and heart, which is the rhythm center, which is the life-giving place, is in F. So this is the word. So we will now try to do it with Omkara. Are you comfortable in doing Omkara? If not, you can do Ah, no problem. So only that, try to catch the place. As I'm saying, you can feel even the bloating of the stomach. When you keep the hand on this thing, you can feel the bloating. How, whether it's your hand will go. You see the newborn babies when they sleep, the stomach goes up and down. Why it's not happening with us? When we are sleeping, it's not because we forgot how to breathe through our lower part of our body. That is the only thing. They breathe. You see the newborn babies breathe from here.
Oh.
Starting the descending order, try to cut the O, say more of umkara, you will feel more vibration. Okay, we'll start from the higher sa. Could feel the vibration. When you are saying more of umkara, that vibration is more. When you are doing, that vibration is much more. So when you start early morning after finishing your losing your toxins, then you start this and you can see as much as possible getting exposed to the panchatattvas, where we are open air, sunrise, good breeze, comparatively less polluted breeze, air. Just before that, if I have a water, and then we sit with the earth, on the touching the earth in some form, that actually enhances our elements in our body, the panchatattvas in our body. So this is the basic. Suppose somebody wants that, if they're having weak digestive system and want to improve the digestive system, what we can do is, after doing this 2-3 times fully, whatever, however comfortable, just stop when you are feeling uncomfortable and concentrate only on the stomach region, and do this little extra, so that your digestive system, by doing this action, inhale fully and breathing out, actually you are exercising your digestive system in Manipura Chakra, and which will help you to, improve the condition of your system. Especially, equally, lung power. You want to improve the lung power, work on the, as I told you, Madhyamaswara. If it is a heart chakra, keep your mind concentrate. Always the concentration is very, very necessary. But as soon as you feel uncomfortable, please stop it. But early morning when you do, before starting the other days, It actually gives energize. Then you will say, Rajam madam, you are very right. Even at 7 o'clock in the evening, I am very energetic, like you. So that will be the most happiest thing for me. Because whatever may be our age, according to the age, now if they want, you want me to run for 10 kilometers, I cannot do it. I accept my age. But even that particular age we want to, whatever energy we should have. I've seen even 35 years old girl saying, I'm a lethargic, I'm feeling tired, very soon I'm not able to work my this thing. I feel very sorry. In my dictionary, there is no lethargy, no laziness, no tiredness, nothing. So we have to be in that condition. I mean, whatever may be our age, if that thing, we can actually improve our health condition, basic health condition, to get rid of many of our other chronic diseases. We can, yes, as I told you, medicine we have to take, it's a supplementary. And especially for the people who are having regular menstruation, please don't do it during your periods time, because you will get more bleeding. So when the bleeding is there, please don't do this practice, because you are exercising the womb more and more bleeding will happen. Okay, we can go to the next. I hope you all understood Nadanusandhana. If memory, if you want to practice only the memory, concentration you want to develop, Nishadam is the best place. Please keep on doing. This is improves your gunas, three gunas, sattvic, tamasic and rajasic, in your regular day, not only in eating, your lifestyle, your behavior, everything, it depends upon that. So all these things are involved. So we can go to the next, or you have any time, enough?
10 minutes
more? Okay, so I can go. So any doubt you have, please let me know. Karta ragas, nothing much to make sense. Like equal to your 10 thoughts in Hindustani music? Yes. This is what I want to tell you. If for some time, if you can switch on that light, switch off the light. Yes. I think now you can see it much clearer. These are the 72,000 nadis. Don't think it's outside. All of them are inside us only. But it is like we can see even the Surya Nadi, Chandra Nadi, Sushumna in between. So all are there inside us only. And you can see the what they have written. Mooladhara C, Swadhisthana D, E, F, G, A, B. This is what the, according to the, what we say, the scientific, this thing, that the frequency produced by the pitch of that particular swara or sound vibrates the, I mean, equally simple, I mean, synchronizing organs, chakras. So this is what I wanted to explain to you. See, for you can see these points. Can you guess? In olden days, the daimas will just, yeah, your daughter is 3 months pregnant. Oh my God, my daughter is not even married. She's 3 months pregnant. My God, it happens. So this, see that it is connected to the uterus. How they know that it is? How the daima, who is not even MBBS degree holder, can make out, because that sensitivity towards the nadi pulsation. Not only she hears the persons, she hears extra pulsation here. That will show her that, and even the pulsation according to the growth of the baby, even early, every doctor will say that the heartbeats difference comes when it's higher and when it's formed, and slowly it comes to the little lower, and by the time it's born, the baby's pulsation, I mean the heartbeat is, pulsation comes to normal. So that's how she can make out that it is, there is an extra. See, that's how all the interconnected. You see in that ankle here, near the padam, you can see that round, no? That is the end of one of the chakras. In olden days, we have, even today, some of the houses practice, before entering into the house, wash your feet and come. And especially they'll say, put water at the back. And to give the fear, they say Shanishwara will come through that or something like that. But actually, that is the cool down. It actually cools. You may have fight outside, some argument, some you have faced something negative. You cannot carry it inside the house. When you are entering into the house, like we have the beating the retreat, they do that and before coming out of after 26th January, because the force they are working with for the marching or the this thing and all, the same they cannot come. Even somebody who is faced in the border fighting and all, and they come back to the house, they cannot come with the same emotion or same condition, mental condition, because that will harm the family life. So that's why they say in olden days, wash your hands, feet, and come inside. And especially when we go attend a somebody's death ceremony, we come home, whatever we are before coming, because we cannot have bath outside, we'll wash our feet and come inside the house, and especially we'll wash at the back of the feet, because something you have taken, you cannot carry that inside your house, so you have to wash it off. And especially they say that's why. So that is because that is connected to our Mooladhara, which is the prime base of our body. Once it is purified because of this, you can't sit there and wash your back. So you can wash that and come inside. The whole body, you are coming in a calm, relaxed manner to inside the house. That's it. That's it. So any questions? Any clarifications? Yeah. Oh my God, that's a big story. Anything to connect that, I'll tell you in the lunch break. Yeah, ma. Yeah. That's why I told you, you keep your hand, especially in Manipura chakra or the Swadhisthana chakra, you can see without you putting pressure, your hand goes up because you are filling air. When you are exhaling, the hand will get pushed in. So that is the way you inhale and so each one has their own capacity to inhale and exhale. What a 25 years old girl or boy can, the amount of inhale they can do or exhale. I always envy Shambhavi, the way she keeps exhaling, my God, her om goes somewhere. I keep breaking my om halfway, two, twice, thrice. She's got tremendous amount of lung power. So this actually, according to the age, because she also practices yoga, Meenakshi also, both of them have seen very. So what happens is, according to the, I cannot hold it that much at this age. But whatever is comfortable level, I do. Like our pranayam, comfortable level only I do it. And this thing, and how it actually, when you are asking, no, exhale, what, how it works, how, what way this is working. When there is a blackboard, you take a duster, wipe it, keep it. Again you are using, so what happens there, you are accumulating lot of the particles in the duster. So when it becomes excess, you either tap it or shake it to remove some of the particles so that you can reuse. When we are vibrating, sound actually vibrates. So when you are exhaling, when you are producing a sound from that particular chakra, you are actually vibrating it. And in the exhale process, which is a process to take out our toxins, we all know it's a basic science, that exhale process is a toxin removal. We are pushing out carbon dioxide outside from our body. So in the exhale process, whatever particle is shaken and get detached from the particular chakra, because you are producing the sound with that force when you are exhaling. Inhaling, when you're doing when you're doing that, actually you are actually shaking, because this is 1,000 petals, it need a lot of power. So when you're doing that, when you're saying it out, lot of toxins
Toxins need not be only from environmental. Even the thoughts, the negative thoughts, negative feelings, emotions, all are pollutions to our body. We don't should not store negative feeling, negative thoughts or any. All are toxins. It has to be removed. So that gets detached. And when you are concentrating, you'll definitely, you can see that the level of negative thinking will come down in your body. Negative emotions towards others, all will come down to your body. So actually, each one of the petals are connected to different emotions. And some other time when I have a lot of time, because it requires minimum 3 hours to present each petal and how it is connected, some other day.
One question.
Yeah.
In one of the slides you mentioned about, there are slots, like prime slots, you know, your
yes.
Word.
Yeah.
Basis the current environment of where you live.
Yeah.
Is there a recommendation that, you know, it is preferably you follow this clock, or can one master the body clock?
It's up to the person.
Okay.
Individuals, suppose if I say 9 to 10, 9 to 10, maybe you have got busy in your office work or some other work. There you cannot give time for that. So you have to select a time where you can sit and do that. I mean, maybe early morning when it's possible at 4:30. So by practice, you can make your body cooperate with your practice. It's up to you. Because as a child, we have all the time in the world. We study whatever time it's possible. But as you are growing up, you've got other responsibilities. So it will be very difficult to do this.
Thank you.
Welcome. Yeah.
You mentioned this, your tiredness, you just feeling tired all the time. But something happens to me all the time. I feel tired very often. No reason for it.
Yes. Because your chakras are imbalanced.
Okay.
You have to balance your chakras and energize. This practice will help you. That is Harmony of Human Body is the book.
Armin
Husman.
A-R-M-I-N-H-U-S-E-M-A-N. Says musical principles of the human body.
Harmony of Human Body.
It's a very old work.
So another book which I follow very, very, very religiously is in Tamil, Sangeeta Kalpadrumam, written by Dr. Muthaiya Bhagavathar. Okay, so I take leave. I think the next speaker has to come. Okay, thank you. So any other question? We can do it in the lunchtime. Okay, so I take leave. I think the next. Okay, thank you. So any other question? Lunchtime. Okay, so I take leave. I think the next. Okay, thank you. So any other question? Lunchtime. Okay, so I take leave. I think the next. Okay, thank you. So any other question? Lunchtime. Okay, so I take leave. I think the next. Okay, thank you. So any other question? Lunchtime. Okay, so I take 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 lunchtime. Okay, so I think much time. Time.
So even when they are recording, the person who is very well knowledge about the music, when they are saying, ask the other person to repeat, so that however they repeat, it's all right, because that gap you are giving for them to practice when they are at home. So there, this thing, suppose it's a shajab, as them say sa, they may not touch the sa in the same way, because very difficult to touch sa and see the initial stage. When the music knowledge is very so what they may say, again, let the gap be. So that slowly by listening to it again and again, then they are singing, they will. So always I tell them, don't, if even autism children, when they have the mothers only, what I tell them, don't put the earphone to the child, because I hate electronic media for the children. Even though for other countries, I'm somehow against it. So I tell them, you put the ear. Because this child, digestive system is very bad, weak. You have to improve on that. So in Gandhar, I will say what she wants, that is Allah or Allah, because I had many Muslim clients in Chennai. So I just recorded there whatever they want to chant. And I told the mother that you listen. And when you are trying to say it loudly, keeping your hand on your one hand on your manipura chakra, other hand on your child's manipura chakra, so that then the vibrations pass through you to the child. And that's how really as non-verbal child today is speaking by this method, because I made the mother of this. That all videos are there, some other thing. I will definitely. If Vani madam asked me to come again, I will come. All depends upon. All depends upon Vani madam. If she tells me, please ma'am, come again, then I'll do it. Thanks. Thank you all. Because until I think 3 days back, there were hardly any. So everybody started calling in the last 2 days. So which is very good. That is the reason why we could not plan for a much elaborate sessions. So now that we know that you know, you all are interested, based on your feedback, we can always conduct another detailed session.
Okay. So now I would like to invite Dr. Shambhavi Das and Ms. S. Meenakshi. Dr. Shambhavi Das is a Hindustani classical vocalist and music therapist. She is a music guru in self-owned Surdami and offers music lessons. She is currently working with autistic kids under the guidance of Mr. Meenakshi Garu and learning music therapy techniques from Srimati Rajam Shankar Garu. Ms. Meenakshi Shuktankar is a Hindustani classical music vocalist along with undergoing training in Western classical piano. A disciple of Mrs. Rajam Shankar, she is an independently practicing music therapist for the last 4 years. She has worked and is working with children with neurodevelopmental disabilities independently and with a therapy center. So you both are working together or one after the other? Okay.